Hey guys, this is Radar Mario 21 back here with more Let's Play Banjo-Kazooie. Last time, we climbed up Spiral Mountain and made it into the Witch's Lair and opened the first world, Mumbo's Mountain. So, how about we actually know, enter Mumbo's Mountain and see what we can do. Let's go! Okay, that's a warp pad, basically that's your way in and out of the level.
There are three new moves to learn in this world. Find my molehills, outslink!
Thanks. These weirdo purple dudes that apparently hurt me because I'm an idiot kind of look like retarded Barneys, but whatever. I don't think there's anything up this tree. No, there's not. Hey, pink dude, let's go get him. Oh, dude, you saved me. You told us that we can imprison five of us Genjos. Totally lame. If you find us all, we'll totally hook you up with something sweet. Alright, let's try it. Let me see it. Uh-oh.
Things a bit slippy, huh? Find me, and I'll teach you how to get up steep slopes.
If you guys haven't realized already, my bottle's voice is Dave Mustaine of Megadeth, mostly from the song Sweating Bullets. I'll show you guys the music video, or part of the music video, and show you where that voice comes from.
Hello, me. Meet the real me. In my misfits' way of life, a dark black past is my most valued possession. Hindsight is always 20/20, but looking back, it's still a bit fuzzy. To speak of mutually assured destruction. Nice story. Gotcha.
Anyway, I'll cross the bridge. More notes. Wahoo! And hey, another one of our stoner buddies. Why did I call them stoners? Well, who else other than a stoner? Than a freaking stoner would just, you know, like, wander off and be all lost and scared and crap and just be like, dude, help me! I'm, like, on this island thingy! I can't, like, I don't know how I got here, and I don't know where I'm gonna go, but, dude, I need, like, a ride or something. Seriously, it's, like, crazy. Right? Oh. And a big bowl! Bunch of big bowl crap! Takes two packs to knock them out, but it's only temporary. These are honeycomb thingies, for beehives. They'll give you 3 life if you need it. I shouldn't need it, hopefully. Oh, and look, it's our good friend Conga.
This Conga tree. I'm gonna hit you with my horns. Even though my aim really sucks. Get off the switch.
And I guess bananas is too much of a stereotype for a monkey, so yeah, he's throwing oranges. Because everyone knows monkeys love oranges. Why? I don't know. God's sake. Okay. That's nice. There's 10 jiggies in every level. Could have figured that out. On my own. Didn't need you to tell me. Oh, for God's sake, now what?
You ready to leave the world? Return to the start area. Skin, eggs, and...
Again, probably could have figured that out on my own. No, you have to explain everything.
Hey, the Conga orange.
I can't put it back, it's kind of impossible.
Even the freaking orange talks! For God's sake!
Why does an orange need to talk to me? And Chimpy likes the orange, so Chimpy's gonna help the fat bear. How awesome. And get a jiggy. Dance. Flip up here. Yeah, your eggs. I know, I'm right there learning to use the freaking eggs.
Time for buzzers to learn the ancient ways of the egg.
I'm listening to your breath.
Hold Z. Press touch C button. Shoot egg.
Hey, it's pretty cool. Anything else?
Yeah, if you use bottom C, you can poop them out.
Yeah, poop out eggs. That does kind of painful. I wouldn't want to do that.
Vertebrae can carry 100 eggs. Oh, you can also use control stick to aim.
Not very well, though, of course. And it's not very egg-exciting. Terrible pun bottles. Alright, blah blah blah, blah blah blah. Thanks, dude. Oh, crap, it fell off. Alright, you know, that Congo's kind of a jerk. Let's test those eggs on him. See what you got, Conga.
I'm gonna hit you. I can't hit Conga.
That's what you think. Oh my god. I freaking jump off the platform. I don't get hit when I jump off a freaking platform like an idiot. Let's go. I think you only have to hit him like 3 times. It's really easy. Hit him, jump, and he hits me for some reason. Guess I jumped a little too early, oh well. So again, let's hope you hit jump. Hit him. And he's done. 3 hits and he's done. Super easy.
Here, come. Take your prize.
Another jiggy. Awesome. Yeah, it's just the first level of this. Don't expect it to be this easy all the time. They are going to get a lot harder, trust me. It's just typical video game fare. The first level is ridiculously easy. Gotta go back to Kong in a minute, but because I need another move. But let's just go up this hill right here. I'm sick of slipping on these freaking slopes. I need to learn an awesome move. Quite possibly the best move in Banjo-Kazooie. Hey, get some notes. Hey, and there's our buddy Dave.
Talent trot lick, Zooty Tackle, steep slope, ease.
There it is. There's that bull hill I needed to find.
That's useful.
Yeah, it is useful. Z left C, blah blah blah. And guess what? I get to move a lot faster. Oh, for God's sake, man. Hit again. He's got to talk to me about throwing my energy. My God, you're annoying. So yeah, this is pretty sweet. I've been using this a lot because it's a lot easier to get around pretty much everywhere when using Kazooie as opposed to Banjo. The only exception, of course, is when you're on very, very narrow ledges when it's probably preferable to move slowly with Banjo. Oh, for God's sake, even really? A Mumbo uses Mumbo tokens? I would have never figured that one out. What a mystery. Notes. Awesome. Another Jinjo. Big old termite. Let me just get my big old can of raids if I don't have one, so let me just roll into them. Just, you know what you do when you got bugs? If you don't have raid, you just kill them the old fashioned way. Another one, my god. These things are never ending. There we go. If I come beneath or inside the anthill or termite hill, whatever. They're supposed to be termites, I think, but I have an anthill like ants. Yeah, I know, I'm not allowed in here. Screw you. It is an adventure game. It's a video game. That's the heart of video games, it's just barging into other people's houses without knocking or permission. It's like, hey, I'm gonna barge in your house and take your stuff. It's just a video game staple. Alright, more notes. By the way, while I'm doing this tedious crap. Oh!
You've collected enough notes to open the first note door!
I'll explain that after I beat the level. Note doors are basically the way you progress through this game. Anyway, as I was saying, yeah, I just moved to Indiana. This is my first recording in Indiana. I moved out of South Florida because I couldn't stand living there anymore and there were better job opportunities up here, so here I am in Indiana. I'm looking forward to life here. Right, now I see a skull in distance. I assume the skull tokens will be used in the skull place. These losers again. Oh yeah, I need to learn the third move. Hold on.
I call this Beat Buster. Just like every other game. Just like Mario and Donkey Kong. It's a grab pound. All you do is press A and C. Again, just like Mario and Donkey Kong. Blah, blah, blah. There's nothing more I can teach you in this world.
Oh yeah, it's not like your molehills were really hidden or anything. You were like right there in front of my face. So yeah. Now, again, bust some huts. Make people homeless. Wahoo. Get some notes. Get some eggs, which I'm not going to worry about because eggs kind of suck. Or they're abundant and you don't really need as many extras as they give you. Jiggy the eye. I don't know if Mumbo is hiding that for some reason, but who cares? It's ours now. It's all video games. Drop bolt to the ground, steal. That's what I was always taught in video games. The Jinjo. Oh, sweet, it's already all 5 Jinjos? Awesome. And what a surprise, getting all 5 Jinjos gets us a Jiggy. Up here, and what? Oh no, it's the penalty cut, this will last. Alright, extra life, it's really useless. I think this is like one of the last games that really use the life system. I guess they figured like I was saying, when Game Overs don't really mean anything anymore, so it's like, why even bother giving you lives anyway? Just give you an unlimited lives and just act like dying is dying.
Oh god, I'm Juju, the Mumbo's telepole. Please feed us with nice egg beaters, because my cholesterol's really bad.
I apologize to anyone who might be offended by that voice. It's not meant to make fun of all Jewish people, just old Jewish people in South Florida that talk like that. Especially the ones that like complain about cholesterol in their eggs. Because trust me, in South Florida, there's a lot of them that complain about stuff like that. Anyway, before you kill them, the last one, go on top, get your empty honeycomb piece. And knock him out, eventually. Thank you. And get a Jiggy. Cool. Alright, before I go visit Skull, I need 2 more tokens, so let me go find an explorer's part of the mountain, so let me get some notes and maybe get another Skull token, and be good to go. I'm gonna do the termite last. Oops, spoiler, that's what you. Did I say anything about the termite? Right now. Until the next video. Whoa, we already got 9 jiggies for the level. Good god. And 84 notes. Pretty sweet. 87 notes. Alright, now where's that? There's a token. Good. Gotta find one more and we're good to go. 4 tokens. Cross the bridge again, blah blah blah. Thankfully this level's really small, so backtracking's not a big deal. Remember how I said I'd have to go visit Congo again? Well, now that we know how to ground pound, there's something we need to take care of by Congo. So let's go. Yep, there's my token. Awesome. And a Gratilda switch? Let's hit it. What happens? Hey, the Jiggy appear on top of the mountain. In this game, there's a Gratilda switch on every level, and those are basically your overworld Jiggies. Oh, I lied about having 9 levels, or 8 levels, sorry. So, wait, are there 8 or 9? No, wait, there are 9. Yeah, there are 9. There are 9 levels, each one has a Grunty switch. So there are 100 Jiggies in the game, 10 from each of the 9 levels, and 10 overworld Jiggies. You get one in the beginning of the game, and then one from each switch in each level. So technically each level has 11 if you count the overworld, if it's that level's Jiggy. Whatever. I unlocked it, I just gotta go outside and get it, but that's after I finish the level, because unfortunately, in Banjo-Kazooie, you can't take notes with you. The notes respawn every time you leave the level, so I have to get all 100 notes in one run, or else I'll have to go back and get all 100 notes again, because, like I said, the notes respawn and you start back at 0. Anyway, here we are at Mumbo Skull, and I'm going to call it an episode right here. This is Radar Mario 21, signing out. See you guys next time. Later.